Every travel pic that you see on your friend's Snapchat is of a plane wing. But what do you really know about those mechanical marvels? And what's that little flippy thing for? Hey there, Wingbats. Trace here for DNews. A Boeing 787 has over 2.3 million parts, and workers on the 747 have to drill a million holes during its assembly. Airplanes are complicated. Aircraft companies are constantly working to update how they design and build these massive machines. They have to fly for decades, take off and land constantly. A 737 takes off somewhere on Earth every 2 seconds, and of course, be smooth and comfy. That's important too. For me, though, when I see an airplane, I see an aerodynamic tube with wings hooked on the bottom. Simple. But in reality,
we put a lot of time and energy in making sure that the wing goes on correctly and that there are zero defects.
That's Kay Keavung-Pett. She is a supervisor at the Boeing 737 manufacturing factory in Renton, Washington.
It's approximately a 12-hour process. The wing body joint is the heartbeat of the final assembly. And if the wings don't get attached, the airplane doesn't move to the next flow day.
This factory builds 42 airplanes every month. That's more than one plane every day. But they still spend 12 hours to attach the wings to the fuselage. That's the place where you sit. That's how solid they fit in there. Todd Gray, engineering team leader at Boeing's Renton factory, is one of the people in charge of this process.
They just slide into the center wing box and then are fastened with about 1,600 bolts.
At this point, the two wings and the base of the airplane essentially become a single piece with that fuselage riding on top of them. That's right, the wings aren't on the side of the plane, they're on the bottom. And not only are they on the bottom, called a low wing, but they angle up slightly, called a dihedral. Wings with a high dihedral make for a more inherently stable plane. Basically, if the pilot let go of the controls, inherently stable planes return to normal flight more easily. But where to put the wings is actually more of a design thing. Lower wings put engines and wings closer to maintenance, while high wings allow trucks to drive underneath and the fuselage to be right on the ground to make it easier to load. And while we're looking at that wing, think about its shape. Wings are designed in a few different configurations: rectangular, elliptical, swept, and delta. According to NASA, that first A is for aeronautical after all, the go-to for powered jet flight is the swept wing. Swept wings have less drag and work better at high altitude, but need more power to lift the plane. The 737, like pretty much all commercial jets, use swept wing designs. Modern airplane wings are more or less like the wings from history. They have a backbone called a spar, ribs and stringers to give them shape, and control surfaces that change the shape of the wing to give it more lift or drag. Also stuffed in there are fuel tanks, but not all wings are created equal. When in flight, air is flowing around the wing beautifully, except around the wingtip. The tip of the wing creates these little vortices pushing up and down on the end of the wing, making it less efficient. So now you will see wings with this flipped up wingtip called a winglet, which keeps the air pressing up on the wing.
They're really there for fuel efficiency, so we get an extra few percent of fuel burn on the airplane with the performance of the wingtip.
Oh, wow.
With the amount of flights that these things fly, you know, in the amount of a month or a year, that adds up to big dollars.
Since a quarter of all the airplanes in all the fleets of the world are Boeing 737s, engineers and mechanics have a huge amount of data on the stresses and safety of these airplanes, and they're still improving. They just started putting winglets on all the planes a few years ago. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. For more about Boeing and a century of innovation, check out theageofaerospace.com. And if you're curious about how a group of kids could come together and build an airplane from scratch, watch this video. Over the past few years, there's been a worldwide focus on STEM education, and nowhere is that more apparent than in the Schools Build a Plane Challenge, where school kids come together to literally build an airplane from scratch. Thanks for watching, everybody. Let us know down in the comments if you would ride in that airplane, and subscribe so you get more DNews.